Now be quiet. All right. This is the case study regarding the topic of cyber ethics, secure data transmission. Right. So very quickly, I just read the paragraph and you read from the LCD. Secure data transmission means that data or information is not being received or modified by an unauthorized person over a network from source to destination. For secure data transmission, we can convert an actual message into an unreadable message with the help of concept of encryption. The unreadable message is sent through network to the destination. If hacker tries to read this message, he or she receives an unreadable message that cannot be easily converted into actual message. This is what I told you yesterday, Chand yesterday. That encryption means converting the original message into some coded form. So that if hacker tries to interfere in between, hacker won't be able to crack your original message. क्योंकि हमने उसकी कोडिंग की हुई है और हैकर को वो कोडिंग समझ नहीं आएगी. ठीक है. सीजर सिफर. When your original message is converted to some code, that technique is called cipher text. What it is called? Cipher text. Caesar cipher is one of the common encryption technique. In this technique, each letter of the word, jaise maan lo Arman word hai, Arman, A-R-M-A-A-N, each individual letter of the word is replaced by a letter, some fixed number of positions called key down the alphabet. For example, if key is 3, each A will be replaced by D. A se aage 3 count karo. B, C, D. Agar D se aage 3 karna ho, E, F, G. Letter D is 3 position down letter A. Each letter B will be replaced by E. C, D, E. Okay. And similarly, Z will be replaced by C. Z ke baad dubara A, B, C. A, B, C. Technique samajh gaye aap? The receiver can identify the original message by using the reverse technique of encryption. Ulta. Agar A ko D mein convert kiya, to D ko dubara A mein minus karna hai. Phir D mein 3 minus karna hai. Piche aana hai. So it will come to A. This reverse technique is called decryption. Okay. Are you all comfortable? Okay, let's start the MCQs. Don't abruptly give the answer. Just raise your hand. Okay. An online class, you also just raise your hand for the answer. Secure data transmission means data can be accessed by any unauthorized person during transmission. Data cannot be accessed by any unauthorized person during transmission. Transmission of data, none of the above. Data cannot be accessed by any unauthorized person during transmission. We are to keep a check. We are to ensure that our data safely travels from source to destination, from sender to receiver. Okay. Which of the following techniques can be used for security of data? Authentication, authorization, encryption, all above. All above. All above. Caesar cipher is used for conversion of actual message into encrypted and encryption technique, both A and B, none of above. Both A and B. Sometimes in multiple choice questions, this situation comes. Four options are there. Two are having the relevant meaning. Okay. So, niche likha hota hai both A and B. Ya both A and C. Both B and C. Both C and aisa kuch. So, read all the options carefully. Now, suppose if any child in this particular MCQ marks A option correct, it will be wrong. Because B was also having the same meaning as given above. Okay? Am I clear? All right. Person X has received an encrypted message and wants to convert this message into actual message. The technique used is called. Yes, Gurkirat. C option, decryption. Whenever you will write MCQs in that answer sheet in September exams, write the correct letter, whether A, B, C or D, then the correct option. Like, don't write alone decryption or alone option C. Sahi letter bhi likhna hai aur option ka naam bhi likhna hai. Theek hai? Chand and Jay, be careful. I am focusing on you both also. Aapka dhyan lecture mein nahi hai. Be careful, I am telling you. All right, let's start the mental ability questions. Open your rough notebooks and online class, you also open your rough notebooks. You'll manage here. A sender wants to send a message having the text as computer. I also open a notepad file over here. Beta, is the notepad window visible? Online class, is the notepad window visible, which I have opened parallel here? Okay. The word is computer. Okay. Now, what the technique he has opted? Having text as computer to a receiver using 4 as key. Key position is 4. What will be the encrypted message? Don't speak abruptly. Solve it on your notebooks. Before solving, you have to pick up each individual letter. Start from C. What will be 4 position after C? D, E, F, G. G. Now, for each letter, compare the options. All are G. Don't see other characters. Character by character move in this question. In all the 4 options, first letter is G. So we can't make any solution right now. That which is correct. Let us move further. O. P, Q, R, S. Now S is also in 4 options. So again, we cannot make any final solution to it. Saket, samajh aa raha bete aapko? Saharsh, aapko? Arpit, Saksham, samajh aa raha hai sara? Aryansh, aap batao. Clear hai aapko? Jyot Swarup? Any doubt? Diksha, Rahul, Aditi, idhar kisi ko koi doubt that what we have done sahaj, aapko clear hai? Kisi ko koi doubt ki kaise aaya? Online class, any doubt? Himanshu, clear hai aapko? Parth, Prabgun, recording is going on better. Okay, let's move further to M. N, O, P, Q. A, B, D. C to kat gai. C kat gai. We are left with A, B, and D. Okay? C option goes cancel. Kyunki C option mein third letter X hai. हमारा क्या आ रहा है क्यू सो सी ऑप्शन इज नॉट अ सुटेबल ऑप्शन ए सेक्शन एम आई क्लियर टू ऑल ओके लेट्स मूव फर्दर बेटे पी क्यू आर एस टी A option is okay, B option is okay, D option gone. D option gone. We are left with A and B. Chand, clear? Next is U. V, W, X, Y. So, A option gone. Left is B option. Okay? Am I clear? All right. An encryption algorithm is used to transform a readable message into text message, simple message, converted message, encrypted message. D option, encrypted message. Okay. In Caesar cipher, for which of the following values of key, the encrypted message will be same as original? Both A and B. This is internet question. Okay. Yes. 19th question. Sunil, Aditya, please wait. Sunil wants to insert an image elearning.jpg into web page. Write the name and the syntax of HTML tag she should use. The alternate text for image should be e-learning image. The name of the tag and syntax. So it will be img src equal to URL of image. Okay. And here we'll be writing alternate text, that is e-learning. Got it? Image tag band nahi hota, pata hai na? We never close the image tag. Right? ये सिंटेक्स है बेटे, सिंटेक्स है. व्हाट टाइम ही इज एंटरिंग द क्लास? व्हाट एवर इज एनक्लोज्ड इन एंगल ब्रैकेट इन द सिंटेक्स मींस इट विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय सम वैल्यू. यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस आल्सो टू मेक योरसेल्फ मोर क्लियर. अब यहां पे जो भी पाथ होगा उसका वो यहां पे आएगा. राइट. आई एम लुकिंग फॉर द सेकंड केस स्टडी. देयर वर टू केस स्टडीज. ओके, वन इज फ्रॉम इंटरनेट, दैट इज नॉट इन योर सिलेबस राइट नाउ. ओके, लेट मी गिव यू वन मोर न्यूमेरिकल ऑन द मेंटल एबिलिटी. We are here, right? Okay, the word is computer word liya isne. We take the word protocol. And the key value is 5. Key value is 5. Convert the protocol word into encrypted coding by using 5 as key. Yes, online class, you also practice. So 5 position ahead to P. Q-R-S-T-U. And one thing more, if it is capital ABC, coding will be in capital ABC. R, S T U V W O P Q R S T T U V W X Y O will be every time T जहां O है वहां T होगा C D E F G H okay and C C will be again T okay and L M N O P Q so this is the coding form right this is the coding form clear सबका मैच कर गया आदित्य wants to ask something all right your next concept is DPR digital property rights I gave one very simple example to you then you will get to know what is DPR you all are having your account on social media sites Instagram Snapchat your Facebook okay when you create your profile on the social media you enter information about you you fill the form you create your ID you set your password and your account is created in that particular media okay now that information which you have entered it exists online the information about you exists online okay that is DPR digital property rights what happens Saket so digital property rights refers to any information about you or created by you that exists either online or on any storage device now what DPR includes any online personal account any social media account any shopping account like you purchase anything from Amazon you create your ID in the Amazon website Arpit we are studying photo and video sharing accounts video game accounts intellectual property and websites or blogs blog is online diary some people are in habit of writing diary they note down their daily schedule in the diary similarly one such diary you can create online that is called blog in blog person they post any topic about their interest जैसे मान लो मैंने कंप्यूटर बुक के बारे में कुछ पोस्ट किया ऑल द मेंबर्स हु आर एसोसिएटेड विद मी दे विल पोस्ट ऑन दैट शेयरिंग दे विल गिव देयर कमेंट ऑन माय स्टेटस राइट सो दैट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट मी इज अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन एनीबॉडी इफ यू हैव मेक सेटिंग पब्लिक एनीबॉडी कैन रीड योर प्रोफाइल इफ योर फेसबुक अकाउंट इज पब्लिक एनीबॉडी कैन रीड योर प्रोफाइल दे कैन सेंड यू रिक्वेस्ट So information about you is available online. That is DPR. Okay. The legal rights of DPR lies with the owner. Like you are the real owner of your own account. Who has created it or who has got it created? Either you tell your any elder to create your profile or you yourself has created. You are the legal owner. Only the owner can decide who all and in what form can his or her digital asset may be shared with other. It is up to you whether you want to share your account, whether you want to share your information with others or not. Jaise your friend is asking for a password. It is up to you whether to share, whether to not share. Your friend says, I want to access your smartphone. Ye pattern kholna zara. It is up to you whether you want to open, whether you want to allow your friend to access your smartphone or not. Got it? Am I clear to you? Now, threats to digital property rights. What are the threats that we face in the case of digital property rights. First is digital software penetration tool. There is one term called eavesdropping. Eavesdropping in cyber stream means that you are communicating online. Some unauthorized person is trying to crack what you are discussing. आपकी बातें सुन रहे हो, जैसे आप अपने फ्रेंड से बात कर रहे हो, and some third person is interfering and listening to what you are communicating. Some third person is interfering in your communication and trying to get to know what you are discussing. Similarly, when you are online, some hacker interferes and try to stalk you and try to hear what you are communicating. Try to grab your information. That is eavesdropping. So some hackers are there who try to penetrate in your system. And they are unauthorized person. They don't have the right. Okay, I have a question here. Difference between authorized and unauthorized. In simple terms, tell me the difference between authorized and unauthorized. In a very simple language, how you can define authorized, unauthorized? Saharsh. Who has legal rights? I have my ID. I have my password. I am the legal owner of that. So I am authorized person. Now unauthorized. The person who has not legal rights, who is illegally trying to crack the information. Jiske paas legal rights na ho. Theek hai? What do you say? Illegal person. Okay? Clear?